Posting new articles from anywhere on the web on your social media profiles is super easy using Integromat. In this tutorial, you are going to learn how you can do that, and I have also got a hack for you at the end of the video, so stay tuned until that. My name is Manuel Gig from Techflow AI, and in this video I will show you exactly how I set up that new blog articles get automatically posted into social media, and I will also show you a hack at the very end, and you will also learn how you can save the data, like the blog articles or anything that comes from a feed, save it somewhere in your Google Drive or inside of a document. Alright, so this is Integromat. Here are our modules that we are going to need for this scenario. We have the WordPress watch post triggers anytime there's a new post based on the schedule. So you can set it to a certain schedule, for example, Monday and Friday, and at 9:17 in the morning, I want to trigger this and search for a new post. And if there is a new post on that WordPress page, then this will trigger. And I set up a filter to check if the status of that blog post is actually published. And if it is published, only then I want to send it to Facebook, to LinkedIn, to Twitter. You could also use Instagram if you have like proper images for Instagram, or you can like create the image on the fly, but that is quite advanced for now. So let's go into some settings that I have here. We are using our business website, and then a new blog article, the title below, and then here are some Integromat functions that are super helpful. We are using the content of the blog article, and we are stripping the HTML, so we're removing the HTML because Facebook doesn't support the HTML formats. And then we are also getting the first 75 words of that article, of that content, because we can't post the full content on Facebook, so we just want to get an excerpt of it. And yeah, in case there is no excerpt in that article given, that's sometimes the case. Not every WordPress blog post has an excerpt, so we have another formula, which is the if empty formula. It looks if the excerpt is empty. And if it is empty, then we want to use the actual content and strip it down to 75 words. I won't go into detail about how this works. This is RegEx. I got a workshop for you where I explain exactly how RegEx works. You can find the link for that in the description below the video. And also for the Integromat functions, they are super useful because they save a ton of operations, and operations is what you're getting built on Integromat. And also, like, to build this without Integromat functions, it's almost not possible. To get an understanding of how that works is very important. Then I also put in the link here, and link name, link description is automatically pulled, and I could even use a date to like schedule it in advance. And I will show you in a minute how it looks like. Then, like, pretty similar for LinkedIn, just without emojis, because it's more professional approach here. And then for Twitter, we just use the title and the link because we have a limited amount of characters available and nothing else here. So let's check how that looks like. When you go to Facebook, to your business page, you will most likely see the Facebook Business Suite, which is kind of new, and in here you won't see the post that you've just created. Just for you to remember, it's not in here, but it's actually in the Creator Studio. So if you go to the Creator Studio, which is business.facebook.com/creator-studio, you will find the post that you have created through Integromat over here under schedule. So pre-published and then schedule, and then you can make changes to it, you can reschedule them if you need to, or do whatever you want to do with it. So don't worry if it's not here, it's not a fault, it's just like the Facebook, the Business Suite and Creator Studio doesn't like work together. All right, now getting into the second part, to save the article to a database, I've prepared, for example, a simple Google Sheet over here with the date, title, summary, URL, domain, and publish on social media, which will be a date for you, so you can like collect it, you can get an overview of what has been published when. You can gather, like, if you have other RSS feeds that you're looking for or that you want to follow it, then you can gather the data inside of a simple Google Sheet like this, to get ideas, to get things that you want to review later. Of course, you can save it somewhere else, you can edit in your project management tool as a task to review or something like that. So how that looks like, I will show you that in a second. I will just disable the other ones and then just run this once. you see how it looks like. And if we go into the Google Sheet now, the first, it copies the format of the first one. So if I just make this unbold and smaller, then the following rows will be the same formatting as this one. Yeah, so this extracted the date that this was posted. It extracts the title, the summary, it extracts the URL. And this was supposed to be extracting only the domain, but I think I need to fix the regex. So I will do that quickly now. All right, so this is fixed and now we got the pure domain here. And based on that, you can, for example, you can filter by domain. If you go to data and then create a filter, and then you can just like select here and then select everything by that domain. If you're collecting like multiple blog posts, multiple data inside of that Google Sheet. All right, now how to do that? Let's go into the setup of this Google Sheets module. I load it up. We have this spreadsheet here. We format, use integer functions again to format the date into a format that is readable, like year, month, day, and then the time in AM, PM format. And that is the day that the article got published. Then we have the title, then we check the excerpt. If it's there, then we use that. And if it's not there, then we wanna use the content without the HTML, like we have already used it in the Facebook post. Then we have the URL, then we use the replace function with some regex, which you will learn in the workshop, which you can find in the description below the video. And we extract the domain of that URL, and then we also put in the date and time of the publish on social media, which is right now, because when we run this scenario, it will publish it on social media. So we want the current time and date. So that is how it works. And here again, we're using a lot of integer functions because they save massive operations. And if you want to get like an integer functions cheat sheet, which will tell you exactly what each function does and how you can use them and have ready-made formulas that you can just copy and paste in here and they will just work, check out the link in the description where I'll link the integer functions cheat sheet that we have created extra for you, so you can save time on these functions and you will get descriptions on what they are doing and how we're using them most likely. All right, let's continue. So last but not least, here is another thing that you can do. You can directly create a Google Doc sheet or a Google document for that is saved on your Google Drive file with the content of the article, for example. You can name it with format date, now year, month, day, so you know it will be in chronological order, and then you know exactly like when this was posted, and you can put the title here. You could even append the domain, for example. And then for content, I put the title here, the H1 tags for the main title, and then also the content here to be in the body. And then I save it into a Google Drive folder. And how that looks like, I'll show you in a second. So when I have a new post, it generates the Google document here. And when I go into the folder, we have the new document here. And this didn't contain any content because it's the same issue, like why it's not showing the summary here. So let me check another one. Right, and how it looks like, I will show you now with create a Google document. So when I run this once, then the data goes through. I have activated the Google Sheet as well. So we add a row inside of this here with the summary, which is limited to 75 words, and then dot dot dot, and then we have the domain here. This is the URL of the article, and when we go into Google Sheets, we see that a new document has been created with the title and the whole content of that article. So that is perfect, and that way you can save the content. We have the date here in the title, so it's ordered by name, and then you can like sort it easier. And that is how you can get the posts and whatever and save it to a database, save it to your Google Drive, save it to whatever, to a Google Sheet, or post it on social media. And now I got a little hack for you, and the little hack is how to publish a new YouTube video on social media. And you can do that easily by using RSS feed. If you don't know how to get your RSS feed from YouTube, here is how to do that. So when you go to a YouTube channel, you got this channel ID, and that is what you are going to need. Then we have this URL here. I will put it in the description under the video as well. We have this URL, so it's youtube.com/feeds/videos.xml and then ?channel_ID. And here we just have to copy the ID and paste it at the end. And then you get the full RSS feed of that YouTube channel. And you can use that inside of the RSS feed. And you can, for example, select if you want to start here, you can select that. I will disable the routes now so I don't post it on social media because that is just an example. And then I will get out the posts, or like the new YouTube videos. I get the URL to the video, I get the image, I get the description and the summary if there is any, and the title. And then you can do the same and post it directly to social media so you can inform your users whenever you post a new video. So that is super helpful, and it really makes it easy to distribute your videos without having to go into each channel and posting your new videos there. Then you can also do the same for a specific playlist. So if you want to like distribute a specific playlist only, or like want to add different text to it depending on the playlist, you can do that by going to a specific playlist, and then you have an ID at the top, which is the list equal. So you have this ID here, you can copy it, and then we have, instead of channel ID, we just put in a playlist ID here. So it is playlist_ID, and then add the ID that you just copied at the end, and this gives you the RSS feed of that specific playlist. So I hope that was super helpful for you, and in case you want to learn more about the Integromat functions, just click the below down in the description and you will get access to the Integromat functions cheat sheet. And of course, if you want to learn about how to use Integromat, we got a full advanced automation course about that. It's called Integromasters, and you can find also more information about that in the description below. Thanks for watching.